Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and my fellow students. My name is Archie Clifford, and I would also like to welcome you and my fellow students to this very special day on the Rockhampton Grammar School calendar. To commence the proceedings, would you all please be upstanding for the singing of the first verse of our national anthem, performed by our primary concert band, conducted by Miss Angela Richmond. The next segment of this afternoon's program. Mr. Brad Beasley has been on the Rockhampton Grammar School Board of Trustees for many years. In 2010, he was appointed chairman of the board, and in 2014, the new primary administration building was named in his honour to recognise his contribution to the school. The Beasley Centre is also home to learning support in the Year 1 and Year 6 classes. Would you please welcome Mr. Beasley to the stage for his 2021 Chairman of the Board address.
Good afternoon, ladies, gentlemen and students, and welcome to our annual Primary Speech Day. 2021 has been a significant year in the history of the Rockhampton Grammar School, most notably being the 140th anniversary from the opening of our school in February 1881. This year also represents the 50th anniversary of the gift of Rita Marta by Robert Mackay Brown to the school in 1971. To mark both of these occasions, an event was held at Rita Marta in June of this year for celebrations and to reiterate the school's thanks to Mr. Brown and the Brown family for their very generous and enduring gift of Rita Marta. 2021 has also seen continued success for our school, both academically and through our co-curricular program. Our 2020 results under ATAR were very pleasing. And as you will see from the slide on the screen, Rockhampton Grammar ranked 11th in the state from data gathered by the Courier Mail and published on the 16th of October this year. It's quite remarkable. Our NAPLAN results also continue to please, and we thank all of our staff members, particularly our teaching staff, for their dedication to the task of achieving these good results. Ladies and gentlemen, there's been much debate in recent years about the reasons for our decline in national education standards. And this debate has centred around the difference between explicit teaching versus child-centred learning. Rockhampton Grammar has recognised the declining national standard for many years now, and we have actively engaged with regulators to urge improvement in the overall outcomes. It's pleasing that the current Federal Education Minister, Mr. Alan Tudge, is taking a personal interest in the debate to further identify reasons for the decline and ways to remedy this. This year also marked the passing of our sixth headmaster, Mr. Arthur Butler, who led Grammar from May 1972 until 1987. Mr. Butler was described as a futurist, and one of the major achievements during his term as headmaster was to oversee the return to grammar of female students in 1977 after a 92-year absence. Our school was also deeply saddened to hear of the passing of Mrs. Carol Butler only some months after her husband's death. Both are fondly remembered here at Grammar, and we again extend our condolences to their family. Mr. Jeff Hadwin retired as head of primary at the end of term one, and our entire school appreciates Mr. Hadwin's primary leadership from 2003 until his retirement this year. Mr. Bruce Saxby has been acting head of primary since term two, and we thank Mr. Saxby for ably filling this role. We also thank Deputy Mrs. Janet Spark, all of our primary teachers, educators, and other staff members for your efforts again this year. Ladies and gentlemen, as you may be aware, Mrs. Kate Harris has been appointed head of primary, and she is to take up this role in 2022. We look forward to Mrs. Harris joining us next year. Dr. Miles has led Grammar through our second year of the pandemic, and whilst this year was not as tumultuous as 2020, Dr. Miles is to be credited and thanked for his ongoing innovation and initiative this year. I think that's Dr. Miles under the hat. And I'd also express my thanks to my fellow board members for their unwavering dedication to governance throughout 2021. After some considerable time through the planning stages, we're now moving forward with the refurbishment of senior girls' boarding, which will commence later this year and have a target finalisation date of mid-2022. It's important to enhance our boarding offerings, given this has been a core competency of Grammar since 1881. As well, we're planning a further stage development of our early learning centre next year, and we're in discussions with the Rockhampton Regional Council about upgrades to Rugby Park. Ladies and gentlemen, apart from our academic performance referred to earlier, Grammar has continued to outperform in many co-curricular areas through various sports, the arts, and our agricultural program. We had a large contingent attend BEEF 2021, and our students represented the school with great distinction. Whilst Rockhampton Grammar offers a full and genuine agricultural program, we're finding greater competition in this area from schools with a much lesser standard, and what seems to be their only purpose of securing student numbers. But notwithstanding this competition, Grammar's outstanding performance throughout AG program will keep us at the forefront of education in this field. Financially, the school reported a surplus for 2020 greater than normal due to our participation in the JobKeeper program. However, for 2021, we're on track for a more normalised surplus. As already reported, our JobKeeper application met all benchmarks and was independently tested by a leading accounting firm and the Australian Taxation Office prior to being lodged. Independent schools such as Rockhampton Grammar are now subject to a new funding arrangement with the federal government under what is known as the direct measure of income. Under this criteria, Grammar faces a funding decline over the next 8 years and thereafter. The school has been working with federal members and their advisors to deal with the funding impacts, given our position as the largest co-ed boarding school in Queensland, third largest in Australia, and being regionally based. However, as a result of the DMI shortfall announced by the federal government, it's necessary for us to raise our fees next year by slightly more than previous annual increases. We will continue our lobbying efforts throughout 2022 and further refine our strategies to deal with the funding decline that's been flagged. Grammar also engaged in a number of strategic measures throughout the year, including master planning, which is due to be completed in 2022, lodgement of our review at the Non-State Schools Accreditation Board, updating our communication process and strategy, and completing our review of subject offerings to optimise same for the benefit and welfare of our students. Hopefully, 2022 will continue a return to business as usual after the significant routine changes we went through in 2020 and again this year due to COVID. We are confident Grammar can look forward to its next 140 years with the same success it's been able to achieve since 1881. Ladies and gentlemen, have a safe and happy break over the holiday period with your family, and we look forward to seeing you next year. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Beasley. Good afternoon. My name is Vidith Wedasinghe. I would like to now introduce the primary vocal choir. This year, the choir comprises students from years 1 to 6 who practice weekly with their conductors, Mrs. Williams and Mrs. Whitehead. Performances this year included formal assembly and the RGS Music Festival. Today, they will perform for us Walk Tall by Carl Strummer. Please make them welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you to the vocal choir. I would now like to introduce the first of our school-based pennants. These are awarded to students who have excelled in their chosen co-curricular activities. The criteria include skill, attitude, and participation. Could I please ask Mr. Saxby and Mr. Beasley to come forward to announce the recipients and present the students with their awards? Mr. Beasley will be assisted by Mrs. Case and Mrs. McNaughton.
Thank you, Judith. Mr. Beasley, Chairman of the Board of Trustees, fellow Board Trustee members, members of staff, parents and students, it's a great pleasure to be able to announce these special pennant awardees. We have a number that cover a wide range of activities across our school, and they are involved in both cultural and sporting activities. First of the people that I'd like to acknowledge and call forward to receive their co-curricular pennant is for their activities as a member of the vocal choir and the Year 4 to 6 signing choir. Ruby Rowland. As a representative in the 4 to 6 singing choir and signing choir, and the Woodwind Ensemble, Kitty Flanady. Last night we had an excellent example of a performance from the school's rock band, and when you listen to them perform, it was really enlightening to hear the choice of words that they had in the song that they had mutually put together. So our award for the rock band goes to Vidith with a singing. Show that talent isn't always isolated to just one area. The next recipient is for the areas of their participation in the concert band and also tennis. Nate James. The following group of awardees are in areas that show creative talent, and our school particularly has a great reputation when it comes to music, singing, dancing and other performance areas. So the following people are recipients in those categories. For jazz ensemble, Lily Eyre. Beginner concert band, Keely Newell. Junior Signing Choir, Isabella Sparks. Strings Ensemble, Delene Somaratna. And Junior Signing Choir, Grace Killian Fisher. Goes without saying that the school also has a wonderful reputation when it comes to sport, and a number of our students gain various honours, not only representing the grammar school but higher levels within our local area. So the following people in a range of sports are recipients that we'd like to acknowledge. Firstly, in the area of hockey, Ethan Mickelson. Also for hockey, Sienna Caton. Softball, Joshua Williams. Also for softball, Holly Richmond. Football, Hannah Davis. Also for football, Nash Mann. Rugby league and basketball, Archie Kagala. Rugby league and cricket, Mac Mazza. AFL, Archie Clifford. Our second recipient in AFL, Noah White. Basketball, Eddie Newell. Oztag, Leighton Steinhardt. Also for Oztag, Hayley Olive. Taekwondo, Ashton Rogers. Netball, Marley Newell. And also for netball, Ava Carolyn. Tennis, Sriyan Gadada. And our final pennant in this group of co-curricular activities, cricket, Gabrielle Stewart. Would you please put your hands together again for such a group of people? Thank you, recipients. May you return to your seats.
Thank you, Mr. Beasley and Mr. Saxby. My name is Edward Newell, and it is my pleasure to now introduce the Primary Rock Band, who rehearse every week with their conductor, Mr. Rooks. With his guidance and enthusiasm, they will, this afternoon, perform Believer by Imagine Dragons. Please make them welcome.
Thank you.
to the primary rock bands. The next item on our schedule is the class academic pennants. Each of the teachers from years 3 to 6 will present their class pennants. These pennants represent the various curriculum areas that we cover in these grades, whether they be class or specialist lessons. Could I invite Mrs. Spark to come forward and announce the 2021 academic pennant winners?
Pleasure on presenting the Class Academic Awards for Years 3 to 6. But before Year 3, there are many who begin the educational journey with our primary students. Thank you to our early years educators who design incredible units of work to nurture, teach and guide our children in the prep to Year 2 years. Thank you Elizabeth Donaldson, Nicole Kennedy, Adair Malhose, Nick Berry, Judy Scarpelli, Sheridan Spark and Stephanie Nugent, Sandra Brady and Sheila Fenner, Linda Irwin and Riley Hunt. They also have the support of teacher aides in their rooms that we are blessed to have work at our school. Thank you all so much for the tremendous work you do for our kids. Working in conjunction with learning support and extension teachers, teacher aides and the many parent volunteers and admin, students have been able to extend from the classroom to the community with ease. The teachers organise excursions to local sites and attractions in our community, with invited guest speakers also a part of the learning journey, both in their classrooms and out in the field. It's also by design that we have many specialist teachers who have passion and talent in specific areas of the curriculum to give our children opportunities in varied subject areas. As always, huge thanks go to the many parents and grandparents who've been able to once again, with restrictions lifted a little this year, to assist in our programs in the classrooms and outside, whether it be cooking, learn to swim lessons, the classroom at Rita Mater, or coaching a sporting team, your help is truly valued and we all appreciate your time and effort. While we celebrate academic achievement this afternoon, we deeply value attributes such as kindness, and empathy, courteousness and mindfulness, and many students have been recognised during our weekly assemblies for these character traits. Thanks children, parents and teachers for working together again so well this year. So without further ado, could Mrs. Hazelwood please join me on stage with Mrs. Case, and we will congratulate the pennant winners from 3L. Sorry, from 3H. 3H. In English, we had Aidan Lee. Mathematics pennant goes to Mahi Syed. Also for mathematics, Aaliyah Lumens. For science, Luke Gibbs. A general effort pennant goes to Addison Maurer. For technology, Daniel Pincombe. For music and general effort, Lachlan Ho. For physical education and cooking, James Peacock. For mathematics and art, Boshu Chen. English, humanities and social sciences, Charlie Irwine. And for English, humanities and social sciences and science, Kanak Pandey. Photo up the top. Can we please congratulate these children of 3H? Thanks, Mrs. Hazelwood. Mr. Lipke, would you mind joining me on stage to present pennants to 3L? And an English pennant in 3L goes to Penelope Moore. The cooking pennant to Maya Williams. Mathematics, Reed Rothery. General effort pennant goes to Emma Hansen. Science, Alexander Ung. For music and also general effort, Daisy Kitchen. English, mathematics, humanities and social sciences, and also art, Piper Kitchen. And for English, mathematics, humanities and social sciences, science, physical education, and technology, Oliver Lau. Please join with me in congratulating 3L. Thanks, Mr. Lipke. Can I invite Mrs. Whitehead up to present pennants to 3-4-W, and we'll start with the Year 3s from her combined composite class. Thanks, Mrs. Whitehead. In Year 3, for art, we have Gianna Torres. For physical education, Grace Killian Fisher. For music and general effort, Kai Bishop. English and technology, Kian Lecker. For English and mathematics, Abigail Rodiger. And for mathematics, humanities and social sciences, and science, Joshua Adakaran. Fours in 3-4-W for technology, Maggie McNaughton. For art, Annabella Fink. For humanities and social sciences and science, Sabrina Poggenpohl. For English and mathematics, Richika Mamadiji. For English and mathematics, Olivia Rumford. And for music, physical education and general effort, Evie Francis. Congratulations to all the students in 34W. Please welcome Mrs. Graff to the stage to congratulate the students from 4G. G goes to Dillian Somarathna. For physical education, Alexander Winslow. General effort, Jasmine Palmer. Also general effort to Valentino Cook. English, Mathematics, Humanities and Social Sciences, Zara Kammerfeld. For English, Mathematics, Science and also Music, Robert Muller. And for English, Mathematics, Science, Technology and Humanities and Social Sciences, Zachary Holtzman. And congratulations to all the students in 4G. Mr. Scott to the stage to celebrate with his 4S students. The physical education pennant in 4S goes to Connor Hursthaus. Art, Ava Creek. General effort, Leo Carolyn. Also for general effort, Sophia Benton. For mathematics and science, Xavier Kandaka. English and Mathematics, Lachlan Davis. For English and Humanities and Social Sciences, Elizabeth Wright. And for English, Mathematics, Science, Humanities and Social Sciences, Technologies and Music, Elsa Lee. Congratulations to all the students in 4S. To the stage to present to pennants to 5C. And in 5C, for mathematics, we have Prahas Pedareddy. for Science, Sienna Caton. The art pennant goes to Olivia Rundle. Music pennant in 5C to Ali Olive. Physical education, Lachlan Robertson. General effort, Jake Hodges. Also general effort, Jordan Hodges. For English and mathematics, Toby James. For English, humanities and social sciences, Edward Roche. And for English, mathematics, humanities and social sciences, science, Japanese and technology, Holly Richmond. Congratulations to 5C, Mrs. Caton, and our pennant winners. Thanks, Mrs. Caton. Please welcome Mr. Kellen to the stage to celebrate the winners with both 5K pennants. In 5K for mathematics, Eva Wang. The art pennant goes to Ruby Wells. For general effort in 5K, Chloe Chua. Also for general effort, Evelyn Lloyd. Physical education in 5K goes to Yuto Yokohama. Japanese pennant goes to Matilda Kitchen. For science and humanities and social sciences, Pramoth Vasudevan. English and science, Megan Wynn. For English, mathematics and technology, Ariel Fasoya. And for English, mathematics, music, humanities and social sciences, Giovanna Sedata. Congratulations to all the students in 5K. Please welcome Mrs. Ruddock to the stage to present pennants to 5R. In 5R class for mathematics, Isaac Campbell. For physical Technical Education, Max Cottam. Music pennant goes to Edmund Rayner. General effort, Madeline Lloyd. For art and general effort, Ainsley Lang. For English and mathematics, Arya Goswami. For English, humanities and social sciences and Japanese, Tino Tenda Noinhotsi. For humanities and social sciences, technology and also science, Alexander Bartholomew. And for English, mathematics and science, Zarif Khan. Join with me in congratulating the students from five. Join me on stage to present pennants for 6M for 2021. And in 6M for mathematics, Harley Aitchison. For science, Archie Clifford. The art pennant goes to Hayley Olive. And physical education, Tyson Carlos. Technology goes to Hannah Davis. A general effort in 6M goes to Ava Carolyn. Also for general effort, Marley Newell. English, mathematics and science, Sunula Muddledge. For English, mathematics and humanities and social sciences, Ekamjot Singh. Humanities and social sciences, Japanese, and also music, Hayley McCamley. Please join with me in congratulating 6M. Mrs. Peckett to the stage to congratulate the students from 6P. And in 6P, a mathematics pennant goes to Joshua Walsh. Physical Education Pennant is awarded to Sid Ward. For General Effort, Asher Clayton. For General Effort, Amelia Evans-Barlow. The Music Pennant is awarded to Snigdha Kaduri. Art Pennant, Aaron Bell. For English, Daisy Williamson. For English, Japanese and Technology, Harrison Chan. For Mathematics, Humanities and Social Sciences, and also Science, Ben McAllister. And for English, Mathematics, Humanities and Social Sciences, and also Science, Lara Farmer. Congratulations to all the students in 6P. Thanks, Mrs. Peckett. Please welcome Mr. Rooks to the stage to present pennant winners to 6R. Pennant goes to Cy Gautam. Also for mathematics, Magnus Connell. For English, Noah Vella. For general effort, Kishan Koshan. Physical Education and General Effort, Ashton Rogers. For Mathematics and Science, Sasha Thomas. For Humanities and Social Sciences, and also Music, Lily Aird. English and Humanities and Social Sciences, Rhea Chakravarti. And for English, Science, Japanese, Art and Technology, Kitty Flanady. Please congratulate all of students from 6R and the team. Thanks, 6R. Thanks, Mr. Rooks. And always lucky last, welcome to the stage, Mr. Saunders, to congratulate pennant winners from 6S. Success, the art pennant goes to Jade Harmsworth. For physical education, Grace Francis. general effort, Jamal Lumens. Also for general effort, Tatenda Mugabe. The technology pennant goes to Shaunak Naik. For English, humanity and humanities and social sciences, Jacob Trippett. For mathematics and science, Vidith Wedasinghe. And for English, mathematics and humanities and social sciences, Emma Hilber. For English, mathematics, science, music and Japanese, Lara Ho. Please congratulate all students from 6S and final presentation in this section to go, very special one. Can I ask Mrs. Moran and Mrs. Whitehead to join me on stage to help with this presentation? This year, three students represented the Rockhampton Grammar School in the QAMT, Queensland Association of Maths Teachers, in the Year's 5-6 Maths Quiz Competition. They were Vidith Wedasinghe, Ariel Vasoya, and Lara Ho. If they could please come up, please. These students won the regional final and went on to win the state final against 13 other schools from across Queensland. They were coached and supported by Mrs. Moran and Mrs. Whitehead after school hours, and we're very proud of the way they performed and represented our school. We have beautiful trophies that have been sent up by the QAMT, and we'd like Mrs. Moran and Mrs. Whitehead to present you with those today. Please join us in congratulating us.
Rockhampton Grammar School Music Festival, formal assemblies and impromptu lunchtime performances in the primary school. Tonight they will be performing Dragonfire by Paul Lavender. Please welcome back the band along with their conductor, Miss Angela Richmond. thank you once again to the Primary Concert Band. It is an honour now to introduce our school headmaster, Dr. Moulds. In 2009, Dr. Moulds became the ninth headmaster of Rockhampton Grammar School. During this time, he has advocated for excellence in teaching and learning with an unwavering commitment to helping students meet their individual education and learning goals. Please welcome Dr. Moulds to the stage for his 2021 Primary Speech Night address.
Good afternoon, Chairman of the Board, Mr. Brad Beasley, members of the Board of Trustees, parents, staff, and students of the Rockhampton Grammar School. It is a pleasure to celebrate with you today the culmination of the 140th year of this great school. Across the academic, co-curricular, and cultural domains, RGS students continue to achieve. Reinforcing our title as the top performing school in central and regional Queensland, the ATAR results for the 2020 seniors were exceptional. Our students achieved well above state averages, and RGS was listed as 11th in the state for independent school ATAR results and the first outside of the southeast corner. Given that 2020 was the first year of ATAR in Queensland, these results are a simple and powerful representation of our students' effort and the school's investment in their academic development and growth. The icing on the cake was 2020 Ducks of the School, Sansuka da Silva, receiving the highest possible ATAR score of 99.95, one of only 30 students in the state to achieve this. Our 2020 seniors are now on new paths, having gained placements in very sought after university courses nationally, and our vocational education students were keenly sought after for apprenticeships and employment opportunities. However, the grammar experience, as we all know, goes beyond excellent academics. RGS nurtures the whole growth of boys and girls, their character, as well as their scholarship. In a world-class setting that develops young men and women to have purpose, resilience, and compassion. This has been the case since the start of the school in 1881. For 140 years, RGS students from all walks of life have studied, lived, played, worked, and grown here on the iconic Archer Street campus, known to the older generations as the School on the Hill. Like so many things in life that are worthwhile and enduring, the founding of RGS embodied perseverance, a quality that we aim to instill in every grammarian to this day. Declared a separate colony in 1859, Queensland was just 1 year young when the Grammar Schools Act was passed. After the formation of several grammar schools throughout the southeast corner, calls were made by local families to establish a similar institution for the people of Rockhampton. In 1870, a piece of Crown land adjoining the then Rockhampton Town Hall was reserved for such a school. As required by the Act, £2,000, approximately $350,000 in today's terms, had to be raised by donation or subscription for the purpose of establishing a grammar school. The townspeople set to work, but the efforts were to no avail, and the required amount was not reached. 8 years later, in 1878, the mayor called a town meeting to again discuss the establishment of the city's first grammar school. 77 of the city's most spirited and influential townspeople attended, and the first trustees were subsequently appointed, who immediately set to work to raise the required amount. This time, their efforts were rewarded. 119 subscribers gave an average of £10, the equivalent today of $1,750 each. The trustees themselves made up the difference, and the money was raised. The Rockhampton Grammar School finally became a reality. The range, which was sparsely occupied and considered out of town at the time, was chosen as the school site, and the government granted 20 acres, upon which we stand today. Whilst the board at the time conducted a nationwide search for the design of the main school building, it was a local architect that submitted the winning design, and the founders persisted with faith in local know-how, just as we do today, awarding the tender for the school's first and only building at the time to a local firm. 140 years later, Schoolhouse is still the heart of this school. Next was a search for staff. Advertisements were placed in papers throughout Australia, London, Edinburgh and Dublin. 122 teachers applied. Mr. John Wheatcroft from St. John's College in Cambridge was selected as the school's first headmaster, and three other staff were also appointed. That was all. And so, after 21 years, Rockhampton finally had a first-rate school to call their own. The Rockhampton Grammar School opened at 11 a.m. on Tuesday, the 1st of February, 1881. Through the gates that day walked 33 boys and 31 girls. In 140 years, much has changed at RGS. Buildings, students and staff have come and gone. Yet one aspect remains unchanged, impervious to the influences of time, our great sense of community. Rockhampton Grammar means so much to so many different people. I'm proud to have called it my home and workplace for 13 years and feel privileged to be the headmaster in the school's 140th year. Our RGS predecessors forged a collective spirit, a baton of goodwill that continues to serve as our school's very foundation that defines who we are and what we are today. For each of us in our time here, let us not be bystanders, but active participants in what is special about this wonderful place. Speaking of active participants, it gives me great satisfaction to publicly acknowledge the enormous contribution made to the school by the Board of Trustees. Their expertise, commitment and belief in the school are critical for its success. I pay particular tribute to the Chairman of the Board of Trustees for his leadership, Mr. Brad Beasley, who not only has great dreams for the school, but invests extraordinary time and energy in facilitating their realisation. Thank you to the school's 1881 donors. We are indebted to these supporters who have demonstrated their devotion to RGS through generous donations to our bursary program. They are indeed proactive contributors who have made RGS a better place, building on the foundations of the school on the hill and helping to ensure a sustainable future. Thank you to the staff, teachers and support staff alike, all of whom I hold in high regard for their dedication and contributions to a successful year of growth in character and scholarship for all our students. I particularly would like to thank Mr. Saxby, who has guided IGS Primary through the last three terms in 2021. This year marks the end of the teaching career for a long-time member of staff, Mrs. Sandra Brady. Mrs. Brady is a stalwart of the Rockhampton Grammar School, a parent of two Rockhampton Grammar School students, and a person who has accomplished great things for us for 15 years. Mrs. Brady, your accomplishments and significance to our community cannot be conveyed in a speech such as this. But please know how much you are loved and respected and how much we will miss you. Mrs. Brady, please come forward and accept these flowers as a token of our appreciation for all of your efforts. The first 140 years of the Rockhampton Grammar School history has now been written. I look forward to beginning a new chapter with you in 2022. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Miles. My name is Rhea Chakrabarthy, and it is my pleasure to announce the next presentations of awards this afternoon. Rockhampton is a great sporting area in Queensland. It is still one of the very few places where Friday sport is still on offer. We are very fortunate at our school that we have so many staff and parents who give up their valuable time to help us train and perform on the field, court, track, or in the pool. This year, we've had success winning Friday sport competitions in AFL, soccer, tennis, rugby league, and netball. In 2021, we also had 15 of our students gain selection in Capricornia teams that competed at state championships. Unfortunately, COVID-19 put a halt to the next step of representing Queensland. Also, I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate Mrs. Victoria McNerney for being awarded the Cole Jones Memorial Trophy for her contribution to the school sport in both the Rockhampton and Capricornia region. Please join me in congratulating Mrs. McNerney. Dr. Maltz and Mrs. McNerney to present the sporting trophies for 2021, including the Philip Borman Memorial Shield for Primary School Equestrian. Philip was a student in our primary school in 2005 and a student in our secondary school in 2006.
Good afternoon. Our sporting awards for 2021. The KW Green Trophy for the girls swimming, Grace Francis. The Jones Cup for the boys swimming, Ashton Rogers. Ford Family Trophy, AFL Most Valuable Player, Axel Allen. The Archer Street Childcare Soccer Trophy, Ruby Rowland. Preparatory School Cup for Girls Athletics, Grace Francis. The Baxter Trophy for Best Cross Country Performance, Grace Francis. Trophy, Softballer of the Year, Joshua Richmond. The Sally Gartside Perpetual Trophy for Netballer of the Year, Tatenda Magali.
EFM Dowie Cup for Boys Athletics, Archie Cogola. Family Trophy for Rugby League Player of the Year, Tyson Cullis. The Thompson Family Trophy for Rugby Union Player of the Year, Ty Lynch. Barrett Cup Cricketer of the Year, Archie Clifford. Becker Family Trophy for Most Valuable Hockey Player, Jade Harmsworth. Tennis Shield, Magnus Connell. Peter Moody Trophy for Touch Footballer Player of the Year, Grace Francis. Richards Family Trophy for the Best Overall Basketball Player, Tyson Cullis. Primary School Equestrian, Innes Brennan. And our final one, sometimes our most anticipated, so we total all our points up for our cross-country athletics and swimming carnivals for the year. In third place, fourth place on 230 points was Kello. In third on 335 was Jardine. And I'm never sure how to end this off, because if I say first no straight away. So in third place, very close, on 350 points, was Wheatley. So Wheatcroft wins this year. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Moulds and Mrs. McNamara. My name is Hayden McCanley, and I would now like to introduce the Years 4 to 6 signing choir. The primary signing choir is now in its 20th year and has successfully performed in many local events over the years. They rehearse every week under the guidance of their conductor, Michael Robertson, and today are performing We Are All In This Together from High School Musical. Please make them welcome. On Mr. Hadwin's retirement at the end of Term 1 this year, Mr. Saxby became acting head of primary. Mr. Saxby has extensive experience in education, including many years as a principal. On behalf of all the Year 6s, I'd like to thank Mr. Saxby for his efforts as acting head of primary. And even though a new head of primary has been appointed for 2022, I'm sure Mr. Saxby's valuable knowledge and experience will continue to be enjoyed in other areas of the school. It gives me great pleasure to now welcome Mr. Saxby to the stage for his 2021 formal address.
Thank you very much, Hayley. Indeed, it's been a long time, 140 years, I've had to wait to give my very first address as the acting head of the primary school, but it's something that definitely I've really looked forward to. And I don't know whether you've noticed, but there seems to be another coincidence, if I can use that term, that in the 140th year that we celebrate the Rockhampton Grammar School, the overall house champions happened to go in order of the first four principals that we had, or headmasters that we had here at the school. And so I think it was very appropriate that Mr. Wheatcroft and Wheatcroft House were the overall champions this year, followed by Wheatley, Jardine, and then Kellow. So what I'd like to do, though, is to say on behalf of all the Kellow students, and I was a former Kellow student, so I feel this very deeply, we'd like to congratulate all the other houses on having to work so hard to come first, second and third. And we know that next year, because it's no longer the 140th anniversary, the order of those flags and which house comes first, second, third and fourth will definitely change. Grace, I know that you're supposed to be promoted to Year 7 next year, but I'm thinking about reviewing that because Grace is actually a member of the Kellow House, and as you can see, her outstanding efforts have really contributed a lot towards the success that Kellow had. There have been so many highlights during the course of the year, and I won't reiterate those because they've already been presented by lots of the former speakers and by our students themselves. And you can see from all the awardees that the success of our school has been outstanding in so many different ways. But what I would like to do is to reflect on a couple of my earlier experiences when I took on the role of being the acting head. And I relate an experience that I had in the first day when I was out on playground duty. And I was in the covered area here just out inside the office. And while I was standing there, I felt this sort of gentle tug on my shirt. I thought, oh, what's that? That's a bit unusual. And I looked around, couldn't see anyone. So I stood there again for a little bit longer, and I was talking to a couple of other students, grade five, grade six students who were about ready to go out onto the oval to play during lunch break. And I felt the tug come on the other side of my shirt. I thought, this is weird. And I looked around and I couldn't see anyone. Then I felt the tug again and I looked down and there was a little person. A little person standing there beside me. And I thought, well, boy, I have to be careful because I don't want to stand on the toes of that little person. So I took a step back, and unfortunately, there was another little person there. And I decided, no, I'll have to follow what the footballers do, and I'll sidestep. So I moved to the side, and again, I bumped into a little person. Now, that was something that was really a strange experience for me, not having worked in a primary school previously. But what it did demonstrate, and over subsequent times where I learned to tie lots of shoelaces and to open packets of food and drinks for people, I learned that in the primary school environment, I wasn't just a teacher. I learned that indeed I was a member of a family. In many ways, I was a parent. An older parent at that, but I was a parent. And so it put a whole new perspective on what it was to be responsible when you are working in the primary school environment. And one of the highlights that has been shown to me through the course of our primary review, which we initiated this year, and which Mrs. Harris will continue next year, was to show that the level of cooperation, the respect, the rapport that exists between all members of staff and the students that we have in our care is of the utmost high standard. The other thing that really impressed me and was different was when I would deal with the preps. The number of cuddles, the number of times that young people would say, "I love you, Mr. Saxby," really took me by surprise. And since I'm not a grandparent in any way, it made me feel in some respects that indeed my role was also that of a grandparent. So mums and dads, thank you for having me take the responsibility of leading the primary school over the last three terms. Thank you very much to Dr. Moles for providing me with that opportunity. It has really been a learning experience and something that I will value and treasure for a very, very long time. I'd like to finish, though, by thanking a couple of very special people. I've thanked the staff as a whole, collectively, on many occasions, and will always continue to do that. But particularly, I'd like to thank Mrs. Spark for the assistance and the guidance that she has given me in terms of curriculum and the way that you teach in primary school. That has indeed been very invaluable. I'd also like to pass on my very special thanks to Mrs. Kays. She has been my mentor in the office, and if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't know half the routines or half the schedules or half the things that require to be done by certain times. And so her patience and perseverance in educating me is very much appreciated. And also to thank Mrs. Scott for the role that she played in a support person in the office area. That has certainly made my three terms here at the school very, very enjoyable. But the last point I want to make is this. The most enjoyable experience that I have had has been working with all of you, the young students here at Rockhampton Grammar School. You all stand tall in so many different ways, and we all know that in the future, you're all going to create your own future destinations and your own tracks, but I'm sure that you're all going to be very, very successful. Thank you, and all the best for the future.
Ensemble. This talented group rehearses every Friday morning with Mrs. Beyond, and are keen to share a song with you this evening titled Stamping Dance by Sheila Nelson. Please make them welcome.
Thank you.
announced our time in the ceremony for the presentation of the Major Academic and Citizenship Awards. Could I please call upon Dr. Moles to present these awards and Mr. Saxby to announce the recipients.
Academic and Citizenship Awards. The first of these is the Westpac Shield for a significant contribution to the arts. And it goes to students who are actively involved in a wide range of the arts performance areas. Our current recipient has been involved in musicals, vocal choirs, signing choirs, string ensembles, concert band, and all other forms of presentation and performances here at the school. Obviously, it took a lot of time to be involved in so many things, and so that shows you again the character of the students at our school. Would you please join us in congratulating the winner, Lily Eyre. Part of our school motto talks about growing in character and learning, and our Edwards Trophy for Learning Acceleration is a reflection of that fact that someone has indeed gained in their scholarship. It's for a student in year 5 or 6 who has made excellent use of our learning support opportunities, and that through those learning support opportunities has shown significant improvement. This year, the Edwards Trophy goes to Alexander McDonald. Our next major award is the Shane Pretty Memorial Trophy, which is for Year 5 citizenship. Indeed, as part of our school motto, growing character, you can't have a strong positive character unless it involves citizenship and service to other people. This year, we have 2 very worthy recipients, and so I would like to announce that we have joint winners. Those joint winners are Jake Hodgetts and Jordan Hodgetts. You will notice that the only way we can show the difference sometime is by getting them to walk a different pathway here to the stage. Cooperativeness, politeness, helpfulness, characteristics that mean that anyone, whether they're academically gifted or whether they're sporting gifted, doesn't always mean success. Some of our most successful people in life have been those who are able to relate to others. And this particular trophy, the RGS Red and Black Association, which is provided by the Ladies Auxiliary, exemplifies that. We would like to announce that the winner of the RGS Red and Black Association Trophy is Lara Farmer. In a competition against other people, you can't always come first. But you can always come first if the competition is against yourself. And that's the idea of where you set yourself some goals, some benchmarks, and you try to improve or build upon those. The idea of doing your personal best. And if you are able to show improvement, then you have become a winner and you are improving. Our next award goes to a student who was the most improved in year six in areas such as behaviour, academic performance, cooperation in class, and so on. The Merrick Family Shield. And the winner is Ines Brennan. The 1990 Seniors Trophy was established to recognise citizenship. In the area of citizenship, the following criteria were used: leadership, the ability to show initiative, the level of respect shown to that person by their peers, their own personal level of courtesy, their ability to make a decision that's not necessarily in their own favour but for the benefit of others, their level of honesty, their commitment, and their consistency. I'm very pleased to announce that the winner for this year is Kitty Fanady. The next trophy is the Staff Trophy, 1990 Staff Trophy for Effort and Excellence. Again, unable to split two recipients here. So I call upon the following two students to jointly come forward and receive this award. The recipients are Rhea Chakravarthy and Emma Hilbert. In terms of academic performance and excellence, our second highest award is the Kate Wilson Cup, and this year the winner is Harrison Chan. Thank you, Dr. Moles. If you would remain there, please. I'd now like to call upon Mr. Brad Beasley, the chairman of our Board of Trustees. I'm going to ask Mr. Beasley if he could present the highest of our academic awards. This award is the Board of Trustees Trophy for the Ducks of Primary. And it also includes the RGS Past Students Association Prize. So in the 140th anniversary of our school, and in the year 2021, the Ducks of RGS Primary is Kitty Fanady. Thank you, everyone. If you can take your seats, thank you very much, Mr. Beasley. Thank you very much, Dr. Moles.
Thank Mr. Beasley and Mr. Saxby, and congratulations to everyone on their wonderful achievements throughout 2021. My name is Ava Carolyn. Could I now ask all the students and staff and any past students that would like to join us to stand quietly for the singing of the school song. Thanking Mr. Beasley, Dr. Moles, Mr. Saxby, Mrs. Spark, and my fellow Year 6 leaders as they depart. This concludes our 2021 Primary Speech Day. Once again, I would like to congratulate all my fellow students on their achievements this year. Thank you also to Mr. Saxby and the staff of the primary school for always being there for us. I would also like to thank our parents and families for their never-ending love and support. On a personal note, I would like to thank my fellow students for an outstanding year. On behalf of the Rockhampton Grammar School, I would like to thank Mr. Kennedy for looking after all the sound requirements for this afternoon, as well as videoing all performances so they could be projected onto the large screen. Thank you, Mr. Kennedy. At the beginning of the afternoon, you enjoyed a slideshow presentation of photos taken throughout the year in primary school. On your way out, this slideshow will be shown again on the screen above me. I would like to thank Mrs. Scott for compiling these beautiful memories for this evening. Thank you, Mrs. Scott. Finally, thank you to Mrs. Kays and Mrs. Whitehead for coordinating this year's speech day. We hope you all have a wonderful afternoon and we wish you a safe drive home and a wonderful Christmas and New Year. If students could wait with their teachers until instructed to leave, it would be appreciated. Thank you and good afternoon.